Hi everybody, this is Crossover Vegas. I'm ZaCaptain here and I got JJ.
Yo!
I got Brian.
Hi!
And today we have... I really don't have to explain this. This is just like Dino Thunder versus... I don't know, the Gold Ranger or whatever. Anyways, wow. This is Tachikaze against...
Gold Paladin.
Gold Paladin, thank you very much. Gurguit versus Gaia. So, let's get straight to the deck profile. So, Brian?
My deck is the new Gurguit featuring from GPT-10. I have some support cards from GPT-10 as well. Mm-hmm. Cards also from GPT-09. 8. Yeah.
So basically everything that's in the G era like, is supposed for Gurguit lah. So
yep.
Alrighty. So then JJ, what do you have?
Okay, so this is the old Gaia build that you saw before, except that I've added things that like Brian also from the GPT-10. So that will include new strikes like this.
New strike, Gaia Dinos, and 100% less Angel Feather.
Yes!
Alright, so if you want to see the deck profiles for this deck or this deck, you can check the links in the description below for the deck profiles, how JJ built this deck, how Brian actually built this deck. At the same time also, you can find a link to our Patreon, so if you like the stuff that you see on this channel, do consider supporting us on Patreon so that we can do more ambitious projects. And all the other links to all of our socials and all the other stuff. Right, so with that said, let's get straight into the shuffling.
Go!
Quite shiny, your deck sleeves.
Yeah, it's shiny.
Shiny. You go Paladin also, so.
Yeah. See me, the tension here is getting very, very intense.
No, it's just
you.
Jinx.
I might need to reshuffle, yeah.
Yeah, go ahead.
Go ahead. Ladies and gentlemen! Right.
Welcome to the show! Please come inside. There's no inside to come inside.
Wow, okay. Oh, it's good again.
Alright. I shuffled for something good. I got something worse.
2,000 years later.
Wow, this is very bad.
That's all, folks.
Catch you in the next episode. See who will win. Either me or JJ. The end.
Cheers, love!
We could work with that.
Alright, so decide who goes first.
Scissors, paper, stone!
What? Okay, I start first. Alright, yep. Okay.
Alright, ready?
Ready? Yep.
Stand up, love, Vanguard!
Okay, my turn, draw. Right, alter. Gotta move here. Stand up. Okay, my turn, draw. Savage Guardian. I will call Prison Bird, I believe.
Yes.
Right, so Prison Bird's ability will activate. Mm-hmm. When this card appears in a rearguard circle, I reveal a great tree from my hand. Mm-hmm. Search my deck for a great tree with Gaia in its name. I'll put it into my hand, and if I do, I will discard one card from my hand.
I wish I could make a pun with Prison, but I just can't think of one right now, so.
Okay, in this case, I will discard one card.
Okay.
Alright, Prison Burn. Attacks the Vanguard!
No guard. Check. Nothing.
Prison Burn. Use pack. Vanguard Yataku.
No guard.
No guard. Check.
Nothing. Damage check. SP.
SP.
Stay there.
Stay there.
Okay,
Prison
Burn. Go.
Draw.
Rex call Gabardock. Activate Gabardock seal.
I show one Gurguit. And I search my deck for a Gurguit in its name. In that case,
search for
Bling Bling.
Bling Bling.
Zabling!
Seriously, what is it with us and the SPs these days?
Because it's beautiful!
Yeah.
Just like the prisms.
It's beautiful, but do we really need to bleed out gold bars for it?
Yeah, this one is actually gold bar.
Yeah, that's what I meant, so.
Yeah.
Alright.
Okay. Boost from Kala, double dot, attack your rear guard.
Why do you want Prison Bird? No guard.
Yeah, I'm gonna retire, so.
Okay, Kinara, so attack 7.
No guard.
Damage, drive check.
Get free.
Get free. Yep. Damage check. Heal trigger!
Here we go again.
Okay, alright. Okay. Stand on the draw. Okay, in this case, I'll write. Sucker Lace.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll call Fang Mammoth. Mm-hmm. Alright,
aggressive forefront from both fighters.
Okay, Gobble Dog!
Oh god. Stomp on him. Okay. With a boost of maybe Chimera, Sarko Blaze attacks the Vanguard. Use Bite.
No god.
No god. Check.
Let me check. I think this is a good trigger.
Stand trigger.
Alright. Go.
Draw.
Right. Don't know how many sword, Gurguit.
Right.
And Gurguit attacks your vet.
No god.
Pink Drive. Let's check. Congratulations. Yeah. Second check. I got nothing.
Okay. Damage check. Get the Thunder Trigger! Thunder. Power plus go set.
Okay. Turn in.
That's a very, very shiny deck that you have, actually.
Yep.
My turn. Thunder Draw.
Is it fitting with the theme?
Yep.
I hope
that
so.
That you're trash.
Yeah.
You do realize you're eating trash, right?
I do. It's okay. Dinosaurs have a very good digestive tract. Lido. Desperado.
Gaia Desperate.
Okay, Desperado. Then I will strike into. I'll go with this guy.
Rado Gigan, Destruction Tyrant.
Destruction. Alright, so strike skill. When I strike into a unit with Engorge, the Engorge ability against the unit skill. When this unit becomes Engorge, counter blast 1, draw 1.
Alright.
Alright. And with that, I will call Tyranno Boot. Okay, let's go!
Dino Thunder.
I'll take.
Got him!
Okay.
That was rather dramatic.
That was anti-dramatic. Alright, I will attack with Gravigun. Gravigun's skill, Engorge. I'll eat the unit. Okay, and becomes Engorge. So, its skill activate. When this unit becomes Engorge, it gets 5,000 for each unit to tie it this way. So, it gets 5,000.
So, it's a big fat in the middle.
Okay, and if I ate 3 or more units, I'll draw 1 card. Then I'll activate the strike skill. Because it became Engorge, counter blast 1. Draw 1.
Alright.
Then I'll activate the Tank Mother Moth skill. When this unit is retired for a card skill effect, counter blast 1, soul blast 1.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean, I made a mistake there, but it's alright. Then you come back and get 3k.
So it comes back.
Plus 3k.
Plus 3k.
And this skill will go to the block.
Not activate, oh yeah, you don't have
enough. I don't have
enough
from
the
blast.
No guard.
No guard?
Yeah. Just hold
triple
it, just double creep me.
First check.
Ooh, jing bling.
Second check, stand trigger. 5,000 to the rear guard. Third check.
Okay. 1 damage.
Damage check.
Ooh, bling, bling. Alicia, bling bling.
Okay,
mine, this is rare.
16 to the Vanguard.
Guard.
Okay. Turn in.
Strike this out.
Dice is out, strike is out.
Okay. Start and I draw.
Whew. Can you mount the comeback? You most definitely can.
Let's make a comeback. Strike.
Two.
Get hold. Second.
Holy Sword of Heavenly Law, good
wait. I forgot
the name. Yeah, that's the name, I checked. So, strike skill,
yeah,
right?
Yeah. Strike skill is Thunder Blast 1.
Do you have Thunder Blast for me again, please? Sorry.
Yeah, sorry. Thunder Blast 1. Thunder Blast 1. I check top 4. And I call 1.
So, do you need strike? So then he calls.
I call Golden Holy Sword Gurguit. And then I shuffle. And then his side skill activates. When I call a Unite card through his effect, I check the top card. I check the top card and I call it in rest position.
You call it in rest position?
Yeah.
Alright, so top card, it's a grid. Ooh, but something happens, right?
Yeah, you're not active it. Activate coil skill, moving to slow. I check top 3.
Wake me up! Can I wake up?
Wow!
Wow! Okay, then I shuffle.
That is totally not the song for it, by the way, so...
Wake me up inside!
Alright, so Lavanya will get plus 2k because of Coel skill, am I right?
Yes, then Lavanya skill activates.
Alright, once you're done shuffling.
Okay. Lavanya's skill activates when she unite when she is cut from the deck. When she is cut from the deck, okay, choose one unit, put to the bottom of the deck.
Goodbye, Gurguit.
At the end of the turn, she will bounce back my hand.
Right.
Yeah, okay. Then I will call Rubber Dog and Quill. Then after that, I give it his skill. Bottom buff one. Choose a card from my hand and I discard. During, and I flip one same copy. During this turn, all my Regas gets 2k.
All Regas get plus 2k for every face up Gurguit in the G zone actually.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that one turns into 4, that one's a 2, and boom.
And also another skill is on Unite, when this unit attacks, I can check the top 7 of my deck and I call choose one of the top 7 and I call one.
Alright.
Okay.
Can you wake up inside?
Yes. Time to make a comeback.
Yes.
Attacks are banned.
So this is 13 by Kiga.
Yep. By Kiga. Okay. From boost from double dot, Quill attacks your band. Congratulations, skill activates.
Congratulations, skill, wow.
Yeah. Come on, plus one. I check top 3. And I call one, which I will call. Another congratulations.
Wow.
And I shuffle.
So it calls over, huh?
Yeah.
The 2k will stay there because it's a continuous skill from Gurguit, so. So right now, how much is this coming after you? 16, this is 20.
Yeah, 10k ga.
10k ga, eh?
Yeah.
No ga. Critical trigger. 5k!
Then that means I can't do anything. Okay.
You can still do things.
Yeah. Attack 7.
Are you gonna activate your skill again?
No. For now, no.
Alright.
Okay. So how big is that?
This is 15 plus 6. 21.
21.
Yeah.
10k ga.
Yep.
Alright then. 10k ga.
Okay. Gurguit will attack your fan. Skill activate. Check the top 7. And I call one. I call him. And I replace congratulations. Thank you very much.
His name is Puma, not congratulations. He has feelings too, you know. He's probably screaming, wake me up inside!
I gotta wake up!
Alright, so this is coming at you at
28.
No gun. Okay.
Okay, put down your deck now.
Okay, given his skill is, when this card is a spirit card from the deck, I can soul charge one. Thank god. And I counter charge one.
Neat.
Yeah.
Nicely done.
Yeah. Okay. Triple drive. First check. Second check. Critical trigger. Critical to Gurguit. Power to him. I don't know how to say the name. Last check. Stand trigger. Stand. 5k.
Okay. 5k there.
Yeah.
Alright.
2 damage.
Yep.
First check. Critical trigger. Power to the Vanguard. Second check.
Okay. Since I can't attack his van because he is at 21 right now. So I'll attack his rear guard.
Alright, I'll let it go.
And I will end my turn.
Alright, so that's like kind of hit because it's only 15.
Yeah.
Alright.
Alright.
Strikes us out, hang on for that.
And Lavanya's skill activates, she flies back to my hand.
Alright, strike gotta go out.
Yep.
Thank you very much.
You go.
Stand on the draw.
Somehow I managed to make a comeback.
Somehow, eh?
Yeah. Somehow.
Okay, in this case.
But it's feeding time!
Yeah. You can eat my congratulations if you want.
I'm gonna strike. And go into
Dino Thunder.
There's no such guy as Dino Thunder. Well, I think there should be, but I don't know.
I'll go into Dinos.
Gaia Dynast.
Okay, so same thing. On strike, it has an engorge ability, it gets a skill, counter blast one. And draw one when it becomes engorged.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, in this case, we're not good. Call for an item. Call for an item. Whew! Yeah! Okay. Now, where were we?
You're about to beat me in the face.
Quite right. I'll take the Vanguard.
This is 15, so you need 5 giga.
Intercept.
Okay. Right. And then I'll attack with Dinos. Lion skill will activate and dodge, so I'll retire one unit. Then it's a skill will activate.
Yep. Which is when this unit becomes engorged, you may pay the cost, which is flip one dinos over.
And I'll choose one rearguard, and I'll retire all units in that rearguard.
In that column.
In the column.
Congratulations!
His name is Bilal!
Okay, and then if I do so, I will counter charge one.
Yes.
Then I'll activate the on strike skill first. The strike skill.
Yep.
Counter last one, draw one. And then activate the GB3 skill.
Okay. Right.
Okay, so when a unit's retired, I can counterblast one to call it back. So in this case, I'll call Surrender Brute back.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's all I'll be doing. Now activate Koala Magnum skill. When this... Oh, plus 3k, sorry.
This unit that you plus 3k, so he's also getting plus 3k.
So at this time, Koala Magnum skill activate. When it's retired for a card skill, put it into the bottom of the deck. Draw one, shuffle.
And choose unit plus 5k, am I wrong? So, what do you want to give the 5k to?
I'll give Serenal Good. And the second coil activate. Draw. Shuffle.
Right. Yes, to do that one at a time because skills can only happen sequentially. So, but right now, this is 29 coming after you. You got no units on the field to meet you for your GB2.
Okay, let's go. Lavanya or Kanzen?
Okay.
Cool.
I toss up. Toss up.
Alright. Triple drive. First check. Second check. Third check.
Ooh. That's quite blank. Alright. Alright.
And with this, I will attack you with a ridiculous size of
23. 24. 24. Okay, no doubt. Let me check. Out of my Vanguard.
Okay. Nothing to stand, but you can stand and draw the next turn.
Yeah. Dice is out.
Dice is out.
Okay, my turn.
Go.
Stand and I draw.
Do you plan to call it?
Let's go. Final turn.
Oh,
try.
That's it.
One more time, Holy Sword of Heavenly Lord.
Can you make his skill? Hammer Blast 1. Soul Blast 1.
Strike skill.
Check top 4. And I call 1. Harinas. Then the rest I shuffle. And since Harinas doesn't have the Unite ability, I don't have to call the top card on my deck.
Can't call the top card.
Yeah. And I activate Harinas skill. Hammer Blast 1. Soul Blast 1. I check up 3 cards and I call 1, which I will call Jeffrey. Then the rest I put at the bottom. Then Harinas another skill activates if I have a Gurguit Vanguard, which I have. Both units plus 3k.
This unit and that unit plus 3k. So I'm curious why you would call that on that side.
Because I have my own reasons.
Care to share them?
Yeah. Activate a Gurguit skill on the bottom. I choose a card and toss one from my hand. H.
You don't really have to show, but yeah.
And I flip. Then now for each the grid face up on my G zone, they get 2k. So now I have 3 on my G zone right now. All my units get 6k.
Alright. 6. More 6.
Okay.
One more 6 on the Vanguard too.
Yep. Then next I will call Gary. And Scarface Lion. And both of them gets a 6k because due to Gurguit skill.
Yeah, and Gurguit gets the other skill, which is check the top 7.
Yep.
Just pointing it out.
Okay. Oh, and Gary's skill, Unite, it gets 3k. Then when this unit attacks or boosted, move into so I can counter charge one. Okay, so here I go. Attack 7. This one is
7 plus 6, 13. 5k guy.
Yep.
5k guard, eh?
Yep.
Guard.
Okay, Gary's skill activate, move into soul. Come charge one. From the boost from Scarface Lion, Harriness attacks your van.
Why are you guys so formal all of a
sudden? How big is that?
This one is 9 plus 4, 13. 13 plus 12. 13 plus 12, 25. 25 plus 3, 28k.
28k, eh?
Yep.
What's the call?
Nova.
Oh. Oh, that's kind of anticlimactic.
I couldn't help it. He has all the cards I had almost nothing to guard with.
That's true.
He's rushing me way too fast for me to do anything at this point.
Well, that's true, but with a Generation Guard, they think actually can get
I won't be able to stop this.
Won't be able to stop that. What were you going to call, actually? Let's just theorycraft for a moment, so.
Okay.
But you have ended up calling Kinarius, I guess. There's two more, so.
2, 4, 6.
One more.
7.
So you actually would have caught this and then counter charge, so charge 1.
Yeah.
And while that side may have been big, yeah, you won't be able to guard. You still have that perfect guard, but you use it for the Vanguard,
yeah,
right? Then the other side will be able to that one, so. Alright. So that's. But you guys can kind of see how these two decks actually function. I wouldn't say that this is mismatched because Brian was pushed far back. Straight to 4 damage, then he countered back and then pushed him to 5. So then it's just a matter of whether if JJ could actually fight back from that matter. So I would say that it's kind of even in that way. Actually, we've done many tests with this fight before, and they've always been very even, I would say. So yeah, but what do you guys think of each other's decks?
JJ, will go first?
Personally, I think Gold Paladin has had the edge for a very long time.
Uh-huh.
Considering that the level of multi-attacks they've been getting on top of the power boost, which is nothing to joke about, truth be told. So it's actually very, very hard to fight back, especially when they get the ball rolling. And there's almost no way to stop their power boost. So my personal take on that is Gold Paladins do have a bit of the outrageous boost. And every boost they seem to get it, so it's getting bigger every time, even if it's a different style of it.
Yeah, Brian, what do you think of the Tachikaze, the new boost?
The new Tachikaze, I can see, we are more like defensive.
Yep.
Defensive, then when they find the right time to attack, it will become very aggressive.
Yes, because the deck itself, if you were to play both, they can actually immediately switch from a defensive stance to an offensive stance in that way. Yeah. Right?
Yep, pretty much.
Yeah, because these two play very differently. This one lets you draw so they got hand to guard, but this one, or guard or callback, or depends on what the case is. But this one allows you to call back units to the forefront. I would actually imagine players actually switching between the two for defensive or offensive depending on the needs of their deck. So, despite the fact that JJ was able to last out as long as he did against Gold Paladin, right, the multi-attacks eventually were too much and he couldn't counteract back because he's got no units out.
Correct.
You saw there's 2 Koan Magnums in there and then plus 5 hit to this. Even this can only hit so high.
Pretty much.
So, but that was still quite a fun match to see, don't you think?
Yes, true.
Yeah, it was a fun match. How do you guys feel?
I would have gone with Gaia Emperor myself personally. Because my hand really wasn't very good. So it's a little learning point for everyone here. But I really wanted to feature Death Ray, that's why I stuck with him. Otherwise I would have stuck with Gaia Emperor and had my units returning. It would have made more sense.
Yeah, it would be more Tachikaze that way, I guess.
If my hand was not ideal. So kind of like Judgment Call here, if your hand is not ideal, you could probably use Gaia Emperor and rush them and try to make the situation change. But if your hand can afford it, then probably Desperate would be a better idea.
What was your 6 damage?
Yeah, Desperate.
Oh yeah, the card was underneath. I was like counting and oops, sorry about that. Alright, so let's just, well, there's not much left to say, am I right? There's not much left to say. And what am I saying, man?
For my personal thought for the new Gurguit is it's not like the same like the old Gurguit. The new Gurguit is tend to be more aggressive. When you strike to the first strike as this Gurguit, as you can see in this video, I tried to do as much multi attacks. Although some people say that, hey, this guy is very hard to use, and also why does his card call in rest? It doesn't make sense, but it does make sense to activate the unite easily. Cards like Lavanya just now, you all saw me, I push back my Gurguit to the bottom of the deck.
Yep.
And you also got such cards as Glorious.
Yeah, so you can actually prop off Unite just immediately just by striking to him.
Yes.
The Unite may be more important than just having the unit at rest. So that one, that's the bigger picture that Brian is trying to point out here. So
yep.
But it is true, I do agree. With the skill being able to prop Unite much more easily, right, then it will be much more easier for you to pop off all of your skills, especially since everything comes from the top deck. So
yeah.
Alright, so that's all that we have to say for this fight. I hope you guys enjoyed the fight between Gurguit and Gaia.
And I hope you guys also appreciate me screaming for just now.
We all appreciate
it.
Yeah, we all appreciate any sort of screaming. It'll be a ton of fun. Alright, so if you like what you see here, do consider subscribing to us here at Crossover Vanguards, and do ring that bell that's next to the subscribe button so that you guys can get up to date with all of the uploads that we do, both regular and impromptu. So if you see a video and if you see that we release a video, you'll be notified straight away that we released the video. At the same time, also do follow us on all of our socials. We're on Facebook at Crossover Vanguards, we're on Twitter at CrossoverVGS, we have a blog, CrossoverVanguards.com, where you can check the depth profiles for these two decks, as well as any of the other stuff that we do on the blog, like event coverages and other stuff over there. And also, we have a Discord server, so if you guys want to talk to myself, Leon, Dempster, sometimes even Brian, is it there also?
Yeah.
Yeah, so you guys can head over to Discord server, you can actually have a chat with us, hang with the fam, and just have a ton of fun over there. We always have fun every day, every night talking. And also do consider supporting us on Patreon. If you do like what you see here on this channel, do consider supporting us on Patreon so that we can get more varied content out on this channel. One such content that we keep talking about is actually the Vanguard web series. So with your support, we actually will be able to get that out even faster, in a faster pace than we already are at. So we do hope that you guys do consider supporting us so that we can get these projects up and running, because we really, 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 really want to see this web series go out. I think it'll be a good show that we have that we're able to provide to you through that. Alright, so with that said, thank you guys again for watching. We'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!